Good morning and welcome to this worship service, funeral service for Thomas Wright. Glad that you could be here. The family appreciates your presence as well. Hopefully as you came in, you received a pamphlet which will guide you through our service. You don't have to grab any hymnals because the music is printed there and all the things that you need. I'll refer you to that now. We begin with the introduction. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of all mercy, and the God of all consolation, who comforts us in all our sorrows, so that we can comfort others in their sorrows with the consolation we ourselves have received from God. Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand as you're able. We'll sing together, Just As I Am Without One Plea, printed on page 2 of the pamphlets. The Apostle Paul reminds us, when we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Let us give thanks for baptism. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. We praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. We worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Thomas. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us, O Lord. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, we'll hear a special reading.
I'm sorry that we're all here, but thank you all for being here. This poem was something that I ran across a couple months ago. When Tom came to stay, I read it to him, and he really liked it, and he asked that I do my best to share it with everyone. So this is for you, big brother. It's called When I'm Gone. When I come to the end of my journey and I travel my last weary mile, just forget if you can that I ever frowned and remember only the smile. Forget unkind words I have spoken. Remember some good I have done. Forget that I ever had heartache and remember I've had loads of fun. Forget that I've stumbled and blundered and sometimes fell by the way. Remember that I have fought some hard battles and won ere the close of the day. Then forget the grief for my going. I would not have you sad for a day. But in summer, just gather some flowers and remember the place where I lay. And come in the shade of the morning when the sun paints the sky in the west. Stand for a few moments beside me and remember only my best. Thank you.
Thank you, Dory. The first reading is from Isaiah. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me and eat what is good. Delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them. And to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and snow come down from heaven, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I propose and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress. Instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle. And it shall be to the Lord for a memorial, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Printed in the pamphlet is Psalm 23. We read responsively as it's printed there. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. A reading from Romans. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we still were sinners, Christ died for us. How much more surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God? For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his life. But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand as you're able. We'll read responsively from Psalm 46 as it's printed. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, though its waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble at its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown. God shall help her at the break of day. Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. The Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I've come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Ryan, Martha, family and friends of Tom, grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As we gather today, we remember Tom's life from the beginning to this day. We share the stories of how we were touched by him with joy and sorrow. We comfort one another in our grief, and we look for hope. I declare to you that our hope is in Jesus Christ, through whom we are justified by grace through faith. Intentionally, I did not say we remember Tom's life from beginning to end, because Jesus says, all who see the Son and believe in him have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. In Christ, Tom's story and our story are not over. This day, as we share stories, we often find ourselves overcome with grief and loss. And we are with one another to comfort one another, to support one another, to strengthen one another. But to remember those stories that bind us together, by which he is present amongst us, by which he has brought us together this day. Share those stories and laugh together and cry together. But know that there is hope. If we consider Tom's faith story, his journey with God, there is perhaps some symmetry in gathering here today. While not baptized here, Tom was taught the faith as a youth at Saint John Lutheran Church. Now we come here to remember the promises of God which were taught to Tom here, the promise of forgiveness and everlasting life through Jesus Christ. In this place was the confirmation of his baptism into the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In this place, today, we point to the promise of the resurrection in Jesus Christ. The 23rd Psalm is a favorite psalm often occurring at funerals. I think probably because it was taught in confirmation, or more, we were made to memorize it in confirmation. The Lord is my shepherd. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You could probably fill in all the blanks because you were made to memorize it. And it is a comforting psalm. The 23rd Psalm often reminds me of the story that Jesus tells of the lost sheep. You know that as well from Luke's gospel. Jesus said, which one of you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? When he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders and rejoices. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that is lost. Now, lest we make this about someone else, we are all the lost sheep. And so what Jesus teaches here applies to all of us. When we say, the Lord is my shepherd, we remember that Jesus is the good shepherd of all of us. And in the gospel reading we just heard, Jesus says, I do the will of him who sent me, God the Father. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. Think about that in connection with that 23rd Psalm and with Jesus, who teaches about the lost sheep. The lost sheep in Jesus' parable does not come to the Savior on his own. He does not, by his own understanding or strength, you remember the small catechism, make himself unlost. rather the good shepherd, lays the lost sheep on his shoulders to carry him home. This is the grace, the undeserved favor God shows us in the gospel of Jesus Christ. It is the gospel grasped by faith that we are saved. And this is our hope. Even in the midst of our loss and sorrows, in the midst of our trials and troubles, this is our hope, the grace of God in Jesus Christ. So this day, as we grieve, as we share stories, we do not grieve as those who have no hope, for we grasp hold of the promises of God in Jesus Christ. Promises made in baptism, promises affirmed in confirmation, promises fulfilled in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Death is real, and its shadow is cast even over God's people. But as the psalm reminds us, we walk through the valley of the shadow because we are taken through by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Because we believe, we have hope even in the midst of our grief, even in our loss. We look forward to the fulfillment of God's promises of everlasting life. For Thomas, for ourselves, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Printed in the pamphlet on page 7, we sing together Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet
The Apostles' Creed is printed on page 8 of the pamphlet. I invite you to stand as you're able. With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us lift our prayers to the Lord, saying, God of mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful God, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give thanks for Thomas, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, for the memories we treasure today. God of mercy, hear our prayer. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember your servant Thomas, and bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your reign, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn. Give us patient faith in times of sorrow. Strengthen us with the knowledge of your love. God of mercy, hear our prayer. You are tender toward your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure. Give us grace to use wisely our time here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks, because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom, and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated as we sing together, What Wondrous Love Is This?
Oh, my soul,
Please stand as you're able. Let us commend Tom to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Thomas. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Let us pray. Merciful God, you heal the broken in heart and bind up the wounds of the afflicted. Strengthen us in our weakness, calm our troubled spirits, and dispel our doubts and fears. In Christ rising from the dead, you conquered death and opened the gates to everlasting life. Renew our trust in you, that by the power of your love, we shall one day be brought together again with our brother Thomas. Grant this, we pray, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Let us go in peace.